Previously on Eric Strebel's Design and Making Channel.
I was asked by a client to duplicate some custom toy parts that he had, and I said, sure, stacking up some cardboard so that we can make these parts, seal everything with shellac, even machined a little bit of brass, and now we're gonna do the clay work and pour the silicone for the A and B part of the mold.
My name is Eric Strebel. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
Did you know that this week's sponsor, PCBWay, has an online free Gerber viewer? That's right. You can just drag and drop your zip files right onto their viewer, and you can check out all the layers and parts of your PCB. You can turn the layers on and off, change the colors, make sure everything is spot on before you place your order. No matter the project, big or small, PCBWay can help.
All right. We're at the point in this project where we need to start adding clay. We've built everything up with cardboard and made all of our keys and supported the little toy parts. But there's a few places that have undercuts, like right here, that need to have some clay. And this guy, for example, we have big gaps in between the part and the cardboard, right? There's only so close I can get the cardboard, so the rest of the distance needs to have clay added in through here. So we're going to warm up some clay, and we're going to very carefully add the clay in between the cardboard and the part to make a really nice parting line, and then we'll be able to put our silicone on top of this and cast the first half of the molds. Okay, so in my pressure tank that is heated, I have my clay. It's starting to get soft. And this is a non-sulfur based clay. This is important to have non-sulfur based clay so that your silicone does not have an issue setting up.
These parts are pretty small, so getting the clay in there by hand is kind of tough, and I need to use a tool to do that. And all the work requires special little tools, either clay modeling tools or tools that I have made. This is a Taper Point Extra Firm Clay Scraper
from Royal Sovereign Ltd, UK. And so I have a couple of these. So here's a bigger one, depending upon, you know, what it is that I'm doing. These are just great for smashing clay. And they're really nice little tools. They're very, like I said, very much like little fingertips.
So I'm just trying to jam the clay into the undercuts of this part or wherever there are little gaps, and then just come back with a tool and clean things up and make it nice and flush with the part. So this is gonna make it a lot easier for molding, so we don't have these little undercuts. This little extra work goes a long way, particularly to making the molds last a long time. And we have to cast a whole bunch of parts. And so I want to make the molds last as long as possible. And if I don't have undercuts and things to prevent the silicone from flexing, that will increase the longevity of my silicone molds significantly. And so I want to do that, and it's worth the extra time so that I don't have to make a second set of molds.
All right, it's all clayed up very delicately right in here. Best I can do at this scale. I've done that for both sides, and this guy is ready to have its silicone top cast. We'll put it in the mold box, and I'm gonna do this same procedure for all of the other parts. I'm not gonna detail those out. We'll just do some time lapses of me working on them. But that's what we're gonna do to the rest of the parts so that we can mold them with silicone.
this part, I don't have any undercuts per se, but I have a big gap in between the cardboard and the part itself, and I need to fill that with clay. Once it's filled with clay and the clay has had a chance to cool down, I can come back with some tools and clean it up on both sides, get it nice and flat and flush to the part so I can get a really nice parting line. The flatter and smoother and cleaner you can get the clay will ensure that much nicer of a parting line. And in this case, where we're trying to match an existing parting line, that's particularly important.
All right, these are our three plates. I'm gonna go into the little mold boxes that I've made. I have videos on that as well. I'm gonna take a couple sides off, wax up everything, put a little clay around the edges, drop them into the mold box on the inside here. They fit pretty tight already. That way, after we put the silicone on the top, we'll be able to just pull out the bottom piece and remove the cardboard, hopefully, and pour the silicone on the other side.
I'm using a GI 1040 from Silicone Ink. I use it pretty much exclusively for almost all of my projects, unless I need something special. This is just a great all-around silicone that is very high performance. They don't sell directly to the public, so if you want to use their product, you'll need to find your local distributor. Into the vacuum tank it goes to be degassed. Make sure that you have a container that's big enough to deal with the expansion of the silicone during the degassing process. Probably take a good 20 to 30 minutes under full vacuum to get all the bubbles out and have some excellent silicone to pour for your molds. Pour the silicone from one spot. This big bucket is not ideal for these little molds. You really should be pouring it out of a little cup, just because the pour width is a little wide for parts that are this small. Try to pour it nice and slow and let it flow out around your parts. You see, I'm not filling the molds all the way up. I'm popping them back in the tank at about half a full vacuum, just to pull out any additional air that might be trapped inside there. And then I'm coming back and I'm filling them to the top, popping the bubbles over time. Let's take the mold boxes apart and demold. Now, our goal here is to try and clean everything up from the first side pour and leaving the part inside. That's pretty tough in this case. It's easy to do with the cardboard, as that it's not touching the parts. The part that's tricky in this case is the clay, and I try to sort of get everything out with a pair of tweezers, but ultimately I fail and I need to take the part out, and I'll have to clean it up and then insert it back into the silicone. It's not ideal. If you can avoid it, do it, but sometimes it's just not possible. These parts with a lot of clay on them, not possible. The one part I was able to keep that in the silicone, but just clean it up and put them back in the mold. And we're gonna add some release agent to the silicone. And I add some here on these through holes. because that's too hard to do with the part in there. And then I add the part back in, and now I come around and I add my release agent only to the silicone, because it's not gonna stick to the part, but the silicone will stick to itself if you don't have a release agent. We're not quite ready yet to pour the B side of the silicone. We still need to add our pour sprue and the vents. For the vents, we're gonna use copper wire. It's something that I very often use. I put a dab of super glue on the end of the copper wire, and I put some kicker or some accelerant on my brush, and then I touch the two together. I'll also add in my sprue, and this is my injection point where we will be injecting our urethane resin. Same process as before, GI 1040, mix in the hardener, stir it up really good, stir it some more, pop it into the vacuum chamber, get all the bubbles out, pour it into our molds.
You don't want to go full on here. You just want to coax any bubbles, if there are any, anywhere in there, to the surface.
You're going to use no more than half vacuum just to let those bubbles come to the surface, and then you're going to let that cure overnight and the molds are done. In the next video, we're going to cover mixing the resin, color matching the resin to a specific color, and injecting it into the molds and removing them to make our parts. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Rock on. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might